Today we are going to see about International System of Units, shortly called as SI units. These units, otherwise called as fundamental or basic quantities. First column we have quantity, second column name of the unit, and third column symbol we are going to use. Length. Length is the first quantity. The unit is meter, and in symbolic format small m. Mass, kilogram, kg, kilogram. Time in second, small s. Electric current, ampere, in symbolic format capital A. Thermodynamic temperature, Kelvin, capital K. Amount of substance, mole, mol, in symbolic format. Luminous intensity, candela, cd. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, these seven are fundamental or base quantities. 1 to 1 is totally different, not connected, basic quantity. Okay, now we have two more quantities called supplementary quantities, supplementary units or supplementary quantities. One is angle and another one is solid angle. So the angle is, you are considering a circle. Okay, in that this is the radius r, here again we have radius, and this is the arc length. The length of the arc is L, and we have theta, the angle. Okay, so this is the length of the arc. So theta is equal to L by R. Okay, similarly we are going to consider solid angle. This angle theta deals with ordinary circle, whereas solid angle deals with sphere. For example, this is a football, but you consider as a sphere. You take some area here, some area, and from the center you have distance r and r. You multiply these two r, the radius, r into r is r square, that's the denominator, and this is the area. For example, I'm considering this area, say A. Okay, now I think you have understood. From the origin, the radius, here again radius, it is r square, and you can view that volume. Okay, so this is area, surface area, a small portion we are considering. Okay, so the solid angle is given by omega, which is equal to A, this area, small area, divided by r square. Okay, now we will see one example for angle and solid angle. First case, see, in the case of circle, okay, we told theta is equal to L by R. Okay, this is theta and this is R, here also R, and this is L. Now suppose consider the full perimeter of the circle. You all know that perimeter of the circle is 2 pi r. So this L will become 2 pi r divided by, the perimeter of the circle is the length of the arc. That means I am considering the full perimeter of the circle. So total arc length will be 2 pi r divided by r radius. Now these two will get cancelled. Therefore, for a circle, the angle is 2 pi. Okay? We say 2 pi radian. So the answer is 2 pi radian. So in terms of degrees, pi radian equal to 180 degree. Therefore, 2 pi radian is 360 degree. This is one case. Next case, we will seeing about the steradian concept, solid angle concept. Assume a sphere. Now, sphere means this assume this is sphere. The full area of the sphere. The full area of the sphere is 4 pi r square. So this is r. So omega is equal to, the full area of the sphere is 4 pi r square divided by r square. So that is omega will be 4 pi steradian. Shortly written as 4 pi sr. Yes, r, steradian. So these are the supplementary units that we have to remember. The difference between angle and solid angle. For angle we consider a circle. For solid angle we consider a sphere. So that's all about fundamental or base quantities, and we have derived quantities. Those derived quantities and all we will see in the next topic. Hope you have understood this topic. Thanks for watching. Nandri.